在瑞士日内瓦的万国宫，联合国的一个重要机构在这里举行会议。这个机构是2006年由联合国大会设立的，取名人权理事会。人权理事会由成员国和秘书处构成，它的任务是为一些最棘手的人权危机找到解决方案，并且呢，建立和巩固规范和标准，以解决各种问题，从获得清洁用水到打击现代奴隶制度，以确保各国的国内政策能够反映国际标准。联合国大会从193个成员国中为理事会选举出47个国家的代表。理事会呢，代表了世界各地的国家，每年都会有选举，大约三分之一的席位呢得到更换。因为投票具有政治性，人权有时要让位于其他一些因素，那这个呢是有问题的。
Obviously, the Human Rights Council is itself a body where the world's governments meet, and that's one of the strengths of the United Nations system. But it's also one of its shortcomings, is that obviously when governments get together, a lot of their focus is dominated by their own political agendas, their own interests. So while in theory they should, at the Human Rights Council, put human rights first, we know that very often the positions they take are influenced by the concerns of their governments with whom they have other political or strategic alliances, and often human rights can take a back seat to the politics of the day.
各国政府加入人权理事会时，会向联大提交一份誓言。这些誓言非常重要，因为它们显示了政府在联合国说的，可能和实际上在国内做的恰恰相反。
So I think really from civil society perspective, we can look at council membership in two ways. First of all, one has to be elected to be a member of the Human Rights Council. So it's really important that NGOs play a role in informing the international community about the human rights record of potential council members. Second, I think for those countries that make pledges as they're participating in council elections, those are really important tools for civil society to use domestically.Both that defenders can point to those pledges to make sure that in the multilateral fora, their government is taking positions that reflect their priorities, but also at home, making sure that basically what the government says at the UN, at the international level, is also being reflected domestically.
中国政府2013年在争取重新加入理事会时提交了一份誓言，他们是这样说的。他们强调将会继续保护中国公民的人权，描述了以往和联合国人权机制的合作，承诺继续法治建设，保护公民和政治权利，进一步和理事会及其机制合作，不过提出了几项附加说明。人权理事会实际做些什么呢？理事会监督并审议世界各地有关人权承诺的后续工作。这里也是各国商讨关键人权挑战以及采取步骤解决问题的重要场合。同时，这里是人权捍卫者和公民社会推动各自的议题，引起对他们工作注意的平台，帮助他们争取自己国家的变化。
One of the good things I think about the Human Rights Council in Geneva is that government delegations themselves are quite accessible. Once one's accredited, one has access to the whole room. Governments are sitting there behind their desks. Often there are breaks in the proceedings where human rights defenders can go up to particular governments, introduce themselves, invite the state delegates for a coffee or a meeting or otherwise pursue the agenda. I've seen a couple of cases where we've had human rights defenders from particular countries who have come into Geneva. And have been surprised that they can just walk up to the government and engage them on these issues. And some of them have said to me, you know, we've been trying to get a meeting with our foreign ministry for 6 months and they won't return our calls or our emails. And here in Geneva, we can just approach them directly and set up a meeting. So there's a range of ways in which civil society can engage.
人权理事会在万国宫的20号会议厅召开会议，知道谁在会议厅里面比较重要，因为每一个与会者呢都有各自的作用。那我们现在来看一下，理事会成员国坐在前几排，然后是非成员国和观察员， 坐在他们后面的呢，是区域组织和其他联合国机构。前方的大桌子呢，是坐的是理事会主席、副主席，以及人权高专办官员。专家或政府代表团陈述报告时也坐在那里。秘书处在这里处理文件，还有发言者名单，以及为国家和非政府组织提供一般性的帮助。媒体坐在屋子的另一边，公民社会也坐在这里。第二十号会议厅有很多用处，人权理事会在这里开例会，应对紧急问题时的专门会议，以及其他活动和会议。理事会每年开三次例会，分别是在三月、六月和九月。每次开会都会有议程，有十项议题，还有工作流程，按日期列出会议的活动。由此，国家、非政府组织、媒体和公众可以知道什么时候会谈到某项特殊议题。
So there are two main outputs that civil society can use that come from a council session. These are resolutions and joint statements. Resolutions can be country-specific or focused on a particular human rights issue and are the main documents that are negotiated during a human rights council session. These resolutions result in a set of actions, which might be reports by UN offices or UN officials, investigations, panel discussions to allow an exchange of ideas and experiences, and so on. Joint statements, on the other hand, are a little bit weaker than resolutions. These are done by a group of states, often cross-regional, and express a concern about a particular human rights issue that might or might not be on the agenda. So it's a way of getting a little bit more attention to a different human rights issue. I should add also that each national government also has the ability to make statements in its own capacity. These are often places where, through advocacy and lobbying at the national level, NGOs can make sure that their priorities are heard.
在联合国的人权体系中，人权理事会是很多人权活动的中心，它也是公民社会参与联合国，让自己的议题引起关注的一个重要平台。接下来我们会看一下怎么做，以及为什么这样做很重要。不过现在我们先做一个小结。人权理事会由47个成员国构成，每年在日内瓦举行三次会议。人权理事会监督各国政府对人权承诺的后续工作。人权理事会是公民社会引起对人权议题关注的重要平台。